I'll start with a little bit of history. First of all, back in the day, Ibis has been around since 1981, long time, 33 years now. And back in the day, we used to have really nice wide rims called the Raya 7X. They were left over from the BMX world, and they were had a nice wide profile, but the problem was that they were kind of having, they weren't that strong. So in the mid-80s, late 80s, a guy named Keith Bontrager, who we've all heard about, ended up cutting down some nice Mavic road rims, which had a great profile, very, very strong, but they were very narrow. And he cut those down, rolled them into a 26-inch wheel, and the first lightweight aluminum mountain bike rims were born. They were really great. The only problem was our wide rims, you know, that were like 25 millimeters wide became 19 millimeters wide or something like that. And so the tire profile changed dramatically. And in order to kind of combat the more round profile, you have to raise your air pressure so the tire doesn't squirm. And so that does some negative things. The good news is the wheels are lighter. The bad news is you have to run higher pressure, so you know you don't get as good a traction off-road with higher pressures. So basically, we've continued on. Weight is king. Weight has been king forever in bikes, especially rotating weight. And the rims have been gradually getting a little bit wider, but really not too much. And so for the last 25 years, we've still been running pretty narrow rims, but with higher pressures as a result. Now that we have carbon fiber technology, that we can get a nice lightweight rim that's also very light, wide, excuse me, we decided it was time to start experimenting with rims that were wide like the original mountain bike rims were, and go for all the benefits that you get. So what we have here is, this is called our 741, which is a 27.5 diameter rim, and the width is pretty monstrous, 41 millimeters wide here. The inside width is 35 millimeters. So that provides you a much more straighter angle on the sidewalls of the tires, which resists, you know, instead of, you can kind of see by just like imagining a tire that's on a narrow rim rounder versus a tire on a wider rim becomes more square. The sidewalls are much better supported, so you can actually, the result is you can run lower pressure and have the same amount of traction. Mountain bike rims are the total outlier with all other vehicles, road bikes, cars, motorcycles, everybody have a ratio of tire width to rim width of around 1:1, 1.3, 1.5 in there. Mountain bikes are like 3:1. They're total outlier and different than every other vehicle out there. So when you make the rims wider like this, you get that added benefit of increased sidewall stiffness and the resistance for the tires to squirm. And it means you can run at lower pressure, which means you can have a much better contact patch. And so you get a lot more traction. The other benefit, which is kind of a counterintuitive benefit, is that if you're riding across terrain, and I'm not talking about pavement, but if you're riding in terrain, having the lower pressure means the sidewall is actually, it means the tire deforms easier, and it basically, it doesn't mean you're going like this, you're going straighter along the terrain. So it's basically reducing the rolling resistance of the tire. And these are documentable. I mean, if you go onto our website, we cite scientific studies where they've proven this. And the other thing you do is ride it and see the same thing.